ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ అన్ని నీ నవల్లో నింపేశావు.
అంతేనా రామో?
కామం, క్రోధం.
I love you, Vic.
So the future of Telugu cinema. Telugu cinema young directors except Nandini. Meerandaru pedda cinemalu manesi chinna chinna pettakalu teesaru. Enti enduku? Em youth tho start cheddam?
Sir, ante adi start chesinappudu we didn't expect the pandemic to hit us, but I think it's perfect timing for us also. I was super excited because nenu ochindi short film background nunchi malli vapas elthunanu anipinchindi. It was damn exciting for me.
Actually had a huge passion for crime films, Tarantino, Guy Ritchie and all these kind of cinema, but I could never do it because all I had was 1 crore. So in 1 crore, if I had to do a theatrical film for my first feature, I had to do a rom-com. So it just made perfect sense for me because I knew that Rana sir wouldn't be there in the film. You know?
I was lucky enough. Yeah,
you, because you are, I got it, dude. Because you are a submarine, man.
First William
film, you are a submarine.
Perfect boy toy and man.
No, so it always chalked it out like that. But having said that, after a couple of films, I realized when this opportunity came by and had an amazing amount of freedom in terms of timeline and everything. I really wanted to really explore, and this was that Coen Brothers kind of thing where you have a dark humor and you also see something shocking and you just see how human nature is. So I went all out on this, and the team was also really, really pumped to do it. So we explored ourselves as filmmakers, and I had a blast this time.
Yes, so Nagi, neither.
నేను లాస్ట్ జాయిన్ అయ్యాను. వీళ్ళందరూ ఫినిష్ చేసేసి ఇట్ వాజ్ అబౌట్ టు రిలీజ్ వెన్ ద పాండమిక్ హిట్ అండ్ ఐ జాయిన్ ఇన్ ద ఎండ్ విచ్ ఐ థాట్ వుడ్ బీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ బికాజ్ ఐ నెవర్ డన్ చిన్న చిన్న స్టోరీ చెప్పలేదు పెద్దది మామూలుగా ఇంకా ఇయర్స్ అండ్ ఇయర్స్ యుల్ షూట్ సో ఐ థాట్ దిస్ విల్ బీ కూల్ టు టెల్ దిస్ స్టోరీ ఇన్ అ ఫ్యూ మంత్స్ అండ్
బీ షార్ట్ ఇట్ ఇన్ 5 డేస్ కెన్ యు బిలీవ్ దట్
బికాజ్ అదర్వైజ్ ఇట్స్ లైక్ యు నో యు హావ్ అ కిడ్ అండ్ దెన్ బై ద మూవీ ఇస్ డన్ ఇస్ 3 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ ఆల్ సో ఐ థాట్ దిస్ విల్ బీ అ లిటిల్ క్వికర్ but again the kids 5 and all now he's grown older for this one.
So it took a pandemic for Netflix to get Nagashun on board.
Yes. Huh? I shoot it in 5 days
and he shot really fast. Yeah,
always the most unique names possible. Chapman, what was you came from short films, or rather when we yeah. first met you were making many short films, interesting ones. You always had a world that's unique. In his regular films, he's always either in space or on the ground. He's never on Earth. So, he's picked feature films like how you guys have picked genres. So, over to you. Meenam, what was your experience in making this film?
This one, I wanted to tell a story in a way that when it ends, when 10 people are watching it, 10 people understand it 10 different ways. It's a simple story, but the characters were made complex.
Yes.
Simple. Like there are two female characters, one who is overpowering her husband, the other who is very selfish. So these two women mindsets, how they play the game.
Nandini, you. Why this story? What was your central theme of picking this up?
Power play in a relationship. You know, I was looking at a power dynamic shifting in an existing relationship, and they were clear that it had to be in a romantic relationship. So that itself was very interesting. It can go so many ways and have so many layers. So I spoke to my friend Radhika Madan, who's the writer of this story, and we were discussing various options and how this could play out. And then she told me that she had written a short story based on a story by Guy de Maupassant. So the minute she told me the crux of Meera, I said this kind of fits. It encompasses the ground for what we want to play with. It had all those elements. And then I started tweaking it. I'm a big Roald Dahl fan. So I kind of liked that big bang in the end, which you didn't see coming. And then you go back and you watch the whole thing and you say, oh, you know, that was planted all along. So, I, you know, that's how we kind of had fun with it. And it gave me the space to tell a short story in a cinematic style. Yes. To give it that little lift and that little finish.
So let's talk Netflix. Tell me, what do you have in the next couple of months, years that is happening in Telugu, especially in the Netflix OTT?
You know, Telugu is a very logical next step for us and somewhere we want to head. But this was a fantastic opportunity that Ashi and Ronnie got for us. And to get these kind of directors in, I think we're a little spoiled about how to go ahead now and what do we come up with next. But, you know, what's been really great is the kind of stuff that's come out from here. And to see the enthusiasm and also the actors and the kind of difference in all the stories that we've seen. So we've stayed around what we would like to believe is a lot of love and power and lust and desire and, you know, all those things that make us human. And I think that this is something that's going to relate across. So we hope to do a lot more. We want to make sure that there's a lot of representation across the country, you know, authentic representation that comes out. And we make sure that this is, you know, the platform where this should happen. And with the support of all you amazing people, we shall be able to do it.
Super. Like, I mean, we've been watching Netflix even before you guys got to Telugu. Now, there's a culture of each city, country, or the globe that we as audience get to view. And that's culture that we'd like to bring out too. And I think what you all have done with this is probably the first step to many things like this. Awesome.
Yes. Thank you.
So, you've done this exercise before. You've made short films with different set of filmmakers,
yes.
Different languages.
Yes.
How crazy are the Telugu guys compared to the rest of them?
Actually, they're all crazy. They're all crazy. No, but it's been really nice. We recently had a first Tamil original as well. And when we started this, we wanted to do both Tamil and Telugu together. And Tamil ended up coming out first because Nagi took so long. No, I'm just joking. No, it was a natural progression because when you're watching Netflix and you have a global audience watching it, it comes out in so many different countries. And when you represent India, you're not just talking about Hindi. You're talking about Tamil, you're talking about Telugu, you're talking about so many more languages. So when we did, when we had Lust Stories in Hindi and it was received really well, we said the next step is to, and with a platform like Netflix giving us that opportunity and us having a home with them, we said we have to explore other languages as well. And there are so many incredible filmmakers, both in Tamil and Telugu. And yeah, that's the reason we came knocking at their door and we're very grateful that they did it.
Tell me, as much as you had these very fine directors, you had a very big star cast for each of these films. So let's start off with I Need Space, so you're because you that's it. And so tell me about your talent. Your actors, they were new.
Definitely.
You saw Shruti in there, there's...
Shruti was not the first choice because she's in the movies. Divya's character needed to be a little subdued and she needed to be somebody who was sort of overpowered and all. And Shruti's a strong character. Like she's whatever movies she's done and how she looks, and she looks very overpowering in a way. So casting her was against the grain. And the guy was literally, I found him backstage in Filmfare when we were waiting for a photo shoot.
Uh-huh.
So he had to overpower Shruti. So that was against the grain. And I just found that interesting to see if that could work. Like, this guy has no experience in acting. Shruti has not done something like this before. So let's put them together in this world that doesn't exist and see what happens.
When Meera's character was written, it's quite a complex character. Chuddaniki ammai, andamaina ammai, she's flirting. She appears like she's playing a game, but there's again a vulnerable side to her. So that whole thing had to be convincing. So Amla is somebody who has the acting chops to pull it off and the looks. So I went and pitched it to her. Straight away she loved it. She was on. JB sir, I was thinking, should I, shouldn't I? Because the requirement was I needed a really dapper looking 50 plus guy. But that a chinna negative streak unto malle vulnerability undal, because he's victim also there. So I, in course of conversation, just told him, hey, I'm doing this for Netflix and blah blah blah. He said, why aren't you asking me? I said,
nice.
He wanted to do it, and then he came on board.
Right. Tarun Bhaskar.
Sir.
Nuvvu crime lo teeskelli. After your watching bits and pieces of your film,
right.
At least the promo is, Lakshmi's
yeah.
character is quite wild.
Yeah.
That's something that I always thought she was right for.
Right.
Playing a hard politician in modern India is what Lakshmi is best for. And you've picked the right one. And tell me about your cast and how.
So, Lakshmi ma'am was the obvious choice for it. And when I heard this event and I was writing also, I was just thinking of her. In fact, my wife Lata, she said, oh, Lakshmi ma'am can do this in JPC. She comes across as very affectionate otherwise and everything, but I think she had this thing as well. So, when I pitched it to her, the major thing is she said she loved the story, she said, I'll do it. And she said that in her accent, I love it, I'll do it. And she said, ma'am, this is going to be rural Telangana. Chesedam. So, annapudu, I said, ma'am, another thing, sing song. I said, I'll kill you, brother. I knew things were going to get really bad from there. But the energy she came in with, and she said, okay, we'll do it. And I knew she was nervous, but that's something that, you know, she put out on the table there itself. Said, I am shitting bricks right now. This is sync sound. I need to work on this. So then we got in the sound engineer and we started breaking down the dialect. How it is said in Hyderabad, how different it is in Warangal and Karimnagar. She actually sat down and she kind of figured it out. So she started talking to her help and other people in Telangana. Every time she'd call me, she'd speak in Telangana. I'd just keep it on mute and laugh and, you know, go back and be serious. But that was a great process. And the kind of detailing she went, even the look for that politician. Every actor did their homework. And it felt very collaborative for the very first time. It was the obvious choice. And then, coincidentally, there was a new girl. She came in and she blew our minds in the audition, because we actually were looking for a smaller character for that role. And she came in, she did the audition, and I said, this is the girl, she's going to leave. And we just placed our bets. We didn't know if it was the right thing to do. She came in for a look test and we just went with it. And I think she's fresh off the block, and I hope she contributes to Telugu cinema.
She's done an outstanding job.
Yeah, so we're fingers crossed on that.
Hey, so you found a new find.
Yeah.
And sir, you?
Nothing cinematic as such.
Simple,
I knew almost all before only. I knew Satyadev, Gavya time.
Yeah.
I knew Isha while I was trying to narrate some other subject. Ashima came to me as she did some modeling. She won Miss Australia over there, and she came back here, and that's why I got connected. Srini, he just casually connects. Right.
And how was it? He grouped though, how was putting the story together?
Very straightforward, simple. Huh?
Because all of them are actually part of this, they have done exercises like this before.
Chalu simple and Sarval Tote, and then simple characters, but execute simple story, but the characterization were complex. The story was simple, but the characters were made to look complex, and they properly did their homework. I briefed them their complete backstory, which we probably won't see in the film, but they knew what their backstory were.
I would come in to the two of you. What was the thought of bringing these directors on board, and why short films? You could have easily made big, long format, 10-hour, 20-hour long storytelling with these fine filmmakers. Why stick to 30 minutes?
Like he said, then his kid would have been 16-year-old. and he would have not given us that kind of time. But honestly, the idea of doing the short film or doing this anthology together was that give these guys the same theme and have them take their point of view on that story. So it's almost like you are talking about love, lust, power play, drama, and it's her point of view, his point of view, and they're all so different and such different minds that they all come together, but end of the day, they're all trying to say the same thing in just different voices. So I thought that was really nice, and that is the uniqueness of an anthology where you give everybody the same theme, but they all do it very differently. And we were very fortunate to have four of them do it. They're all really interesting minds, and they've done a really good job, and yeah.
So tell me guys, now Feb 19 is when all the films come out at once.
Yes.
And let's start with you, Sankar. What is it that, as an audience, that we'll get up with once your film is done?
Nagi.
Pass.
What will we get up with? I don't know. I think it's just, I hope like when you get up, you won't touch your phone for an hour, basically. That's maybe that's what you'll get up with. And also just you know, welcome to a lot of new filmmakers who just understand now that Netflix is in Telugu. And these four filmmakers have made such four different stories that these people are listening to like really crazy stuff.
Actually, people have been kind of guessing who's done what, and they've got it all wrong.
They thought
Sankalp has done Nagi's film. I've done Sankalp's film.
This is sci-fi.
Nagi's done mine. I think only thing they linked is Tarun
is clarity.
Yeah, because of the Telangana thing. They thought Tarun has done. So I think they're gonna go what for a bit. So hopefully it'll be a good what at the end of it.
So, these are filmmakers that are established. They get to tell new and interesting stories on a platform which is global. What is it that filmmakers have to be ready for? What is it that, because it's very new for all of us. There's a format that you can change from 2.5 hours, 3 hours to something else. It's actually a mind shift for us. And the fact that we're not watching it in a theater, we get to watch it at home, is still not as audience, but as filmmakers and writers and actors, that becomes the problem. So tell us, what is it that the filmmakers need to look for if they have to get a check off hand?
To the point.
Not yet.
Yeah, get simple. What do you pay for? What kind of content?
the idea is always like to tell something that's really like, I'll go back to the word authentic. Something that's honest and true to what it is that you want to say. Authenticity is not always that's something that's only grounded or from like a smaller town. It can be something that is, you know, authentic to the world that it's meant to be, even if that world is a make-believe world. It just needs to be true to where it is, because I think that's the biggest learning that we've had, is that the audience smells it. They know exactly why you've made what you've made. And that's what we're hoping to like
super
bring
smart.
In people. Like, for example, we don't give briefs. We don't say that this is what we're looking for. We want you to come and tell us what it is that you want to say. And I think somehow that passion translates, and that's essentially how we look at it. It sounds almost utopian, but we want to try and stay like that. We don't want to say that we're looking for three comedies, two
right.
films in Telugu, one film in Tamil. We want to do something in... you know, it's not that. The idea is the story, because we do believe that we subtitle and dub our films in about 30 languages. So it should be agnostic, because a great story can come from anywhere and go everywhere, right? And I think the most exciting thing is always like to see your film on a row alongside with other people in the world.
Yeah.
And people making the choice. And, you know, we all believe at Netflix that we have the best talent in India. We just have to try and just make sure that the rest of the world gets to see it. And so. No pressure, guys.
I want to add to this that this has been one of the best producer experiences I've had. And I think I speak for
yes, all of us.
Absolutely.
It kind of gave us a little more responsibility that, you know, they're trusting us with this. Let's really put our heads into it. And Nagi was not yet there at that time. So three of us kind of ran by our stories, and then we gave each other our opinions on what was working, what was not. We had that kind of thing. So we were very conscious that let's make this work. Let's put our best foot forward. And that was very liberating for us. There was nobody holding us by the scruff of the neck and saying, what is that? They went and saw the final cut. That's it. And then they gave us their comments on that. And that was it. It was beautiful.
So 19th of February.
Yes, even, 19th of February.
The day you complete 11 years.
Which is a special day for Rana Rathbhati as well. Tell us why, Rana.
Tell us why? Because you've been an actor now 11 years. That same day. With
video. Hey. Yeah.
So, yeah, it's a full circle in a lot of ways.
There you go. So,
19th February.
19th of Feb, Telugu cinema audience, which is young new filmmakers Netflix lo pitta kalato chustaru. So all the best to all of you guys, and thank you Netflix for doing this. Thank you RSVP for putting this together. We're hoping you all do many more unique films and break the mainstream mold with new and interesting voices that you find.
For sure.
And see you guys Feb 19th.